Ivan Klausar, thank you for joining me in the studio today. In some previous episodes, I discussed heavy structure gel, modelling paste and black lava gel. Now, there are links below if you want to go into the description and go and see them first, or you can just watch this particular one, which I'm going to be talking about glass bead texture gel. Now, it's exactly the same as the black lava gel, but it's got glass beads in it as well, and it's all colourless. And okay, so you can mix this with colour, you can add colour to it, and there are videos that I've done using this particular medium. Again, if you need to click on the description below and follow those links. So what does this say on the back of this tub? Now, these range between £5 and £10 in the UK. You can get them around the world. I'm sure this is a particular make, but I'm not promoting this manufacturer. It's just the ones I prefer to use. So yeah, feel free to go and buy and purchase anything you want, okay? A granular paste containing tiny colourless glass beads. Now, you need to stir this well before use. You can use it alone for a colourless result, or mix with acrylic colour, like I've done with the yellow there. But if you do see a difference in colour, then if you mix in a colour with this, and this looks slightly lighter than that one, say in yellow, in this particular instance, then you need to add a bit more acrylic paint to it to get it to the same colour, because there is no colour shift, and colour shift means it's not going to get lighter or darker either way when it dries. Okay, it can be overpainted when dry, so you can put it on neat and then overpaint it, very similar to, well, any one of these you can do that with, unlike the modelling paste there. Do not over thin with water, and apply with a brush or knife and clean the equipment immediately after water. And as I've said on previous ones, you need to use warm water, because that's always the best way to get acrylic paint out of the bristles, because you don't need it to gather into the ferrule. And use some baby soap or some hand soap or whatever soap you've got to hand, and then make sure you wash it really well, and to get that soap out of the brush, because you don't want it to go onto your canvas at a later stage and cause you problems with it won't adhere so well if it's soap in it, because it's going to react. But yeah, really good, give a good rinse anyway. Okay, so let's have a look at this puppy, shall we? Let's take the lid off. So as you can see, it's a white paste, and it's got some clear glass beads inside. And I'll just take some out for you to see. I don't know if you can see that so well, but yeah, there's little tiny glass beads in there. And it is very similar to the lava gel, but it's just been replaced with glass beads. So again, looking at our canvas, we'll just put a bit of this on neat, because I don't want to waste paint. And you can see the glass beads now, and you can hear them scraping. This does actually dry clear, and you can build that up, and it'll give the light will catch these little beads. And if you haven't painted them, obviously, if there's no paint on that, then obviously it will catch the light. Or you can just play with this. You can lay this over a pre-painted area, and that'll dry clear, and it'll show the colour through it. I've done that before. Or you can add paint to it, and it's just a way of putting texture onto your canvas. And that's all I have to say about that little thing. So yes, they're all related, they're all basically the same thing. Some are thicker than others, and some got more things in them than others, so they're all different, but they're basically the same. Sorry about that, my bulb just went pop. Anyway, as I was saying, yes, so they're all the same, they just they're different thicknesses, viscosities. There's different viscosities and different additives to them. So all that remains me to say on this particular instance is thank you very much for watching. I'm about to change my light bulb now, because I don't want another one to blow. And yes, join me on Facebook and Twitter. I do weekly updates and email corners once a month, which will take you, I answer some questions. I've also got a membership page now on Facebook, so if you want to come along there, join me, send me a friend request, and I will add you to the group. It is a closed group, so there's over, there's hundreds of people in there that will all want to share work and help and advice and that type of thing. So yes, it's growing really well, my Clive's Art Family Community. So yep, thank you very much for watching. I'll catch you on the next one, and don't forget, give me that thumbs up, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye. In the meantime, thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already done so. Keep an eye out for my weekly updates. Join me on Facebook, they're always there, and they'll let you know what's coming up in that particular week. So may God be go with you. I'm Clive from Clivesart. Take care, thank you very much. Don't forget to give me that thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already done so. Bye bye.